think of myself like a CSI for planet Earth. I'm a detective collecting clues, trying to put together the puzzle of Earth's climate history so that we can better understand our future. My name is Andrea Dutton, and I'm a paleoclimatologist. A lot of my work has focused on a past warm period that we call the last interglacial, which was before the last ice age. And we're looking at that because we want to understand the last time it was warm, how did the ice sheets respond? How quickly did sea level rise? And how high did it rise? And that helps us to understand the dynamics of Earth's climate system. I'm a field geologist, so we go out into the field to collect fossil corals that lived near the sea surface, and that's what we use to track the position of sea level through time. When we're in the field, we do a lot of surveying to determine the exact elevation of the corals that we are collecting, and we also describe the reef outcrops in great detail. And then we bring those samples back here to the lab, where we dissolve them and date them using a radiometric technique. So when corals grow, they incorporate trace amounts of uranium into their skeleton. And we use that because the uranium decays slowly over time. So it's like a clock ticking away. And by measuring the amounts of uranium in the coral, we can figure out exactly how old it is. By looking at these fossil corals, we can determine how high sea level rose when the planet warms. And also how quickly that happened. And that's the burning question that everyone wants to know about our future. The data that we are collecting using these fossilized corals to reconstruct past sea level helps us to calibrate the models that we're using to project sea level rise into the future. Sea level rise is impacting people's lives today. And so that is what drives me and motivates me, not just in the research line of my work, but also to communicate the science to the people that it's affecting. We are playing catch up for the sea level rise that we have already witnessed, and we know there's going to be more in the future. If we want to get ahead of this problem, we need to be thinking more ambitiously and more creatively about how to tackle it together. A lot of people think of my work as trying to save planet Earth, but I'm a geologist, and the Earth has been here for 4.5 billion years. I'm actually not worried about the planet. It will still be here. It'll be a different place. What I'm worried about is how we are going to exist in that new world.